The Reserve Bank of New Zealand has cut interest rates by 50 basis points again. Joining me now is Jack Nyhof, our New Zealand correspondent. Jack, just talk us through the RBNZ's movements today.
Yeah, this 50 basis point cut was widely expected. Some economists thought that it could have went further. Others were thinking that maybe it would have been 25 basis points cut here. The official cash rate now down from 5.25% to 4.75%. This is the second cut of the year. The central bank says consumer price inflation is coming down as well. It's now within that bandwidth of 1 to 3%. We'll find out that exact figure when it's released next week, but the central bank has hinted that it's closer to that 2% midpoint now. Now, the committee has acknowledged that domestic activity in New Zealand is weak. Now, remember, New Zealand has recently come out of a double dip recession, so GDP growth is very slow at the moment. It's also pointed overseas to places like the United States and China, saying that growth is slow there and geopolitical tensions remain a significant headwind for world economic activity. Compare that rate to Australia, which is sitting at 4.35%. So second cut of the year, and it's very welcomed by New Zealanders.
Yeah, Jack, the RBNZ lifted rates a lot more aggressively in New Zealand compared to the Reserve Bank of Australia here, and it basically tipped your economy in New Zealand there into recession. Just talk us through what the vibe's like on the ground in New Zealand at the moment. Are consumers starting to feel confident again, or are they still pretty tight with their spending?
Yeah, this announcement really feels like that turning point, that weight coming off the shoulders of New Zealanders. If you remember back to 2022, one of the quarters, inflation was as high as 7.3%. Now it's come down to 2%. So prices rising less aggressively. That's good news as well. Now, a recent comparison between supermarket prices in Australia and New Zealand for a shop that's worth about $330 Australian dollars, it's about $70 to $80 more for that same shop, Australian currency in New Zealand. So prices are a lot higher. The government has axed thousands of public sector jobs. So unemployment is also rising in New Zealand. But with that inflation coming down, that's easing pressure of mortgage rates, easing pressure of household spending. It's certainly being welcomed by Kiwis, and the New Zealand government also trying to take a little bit of credit for this as well, despite being elected only late last year.
Jack, thanks for coming on the show.